Hi, I'm Ted from Roarockit, and today we're going to demonstrate what actually happens when we vacuum veneer different materials together, and what's actually causing that material to stay in that three-dimensional shape like what we have here. The materials that I'm going to show you today are Canadian maple, which is 1/16 of an inch thick, and then another material that's typically used for vacuum veneering is 1/8 inch Baltic birch. I have this little demonstration rigged up. It's multiple layers of veneer that have been formed into an arc like this, and then I've taken and I've glued the last 1 inch of the ends of this. And when I open it up, it'll give you a good idea of what's actually happening to that glue line and the reason why they're staying in this three-dimensional shape. So let me take this off. Okay, so you can see that we've got this shape, and it's glued at the end, so the ends can't move. And so as I open it up, what's happening is the outside layer is traveling significantly more than the inside layer, and it's the shear line of the glue, okay, the fact that the material when it opens up wants to slide, okay, that allows it to hold its shape. And so when it's like this, the only way that it can start to come back is for the glue line to shear like this. And glue lines are incredibly strong, and it would be very difficult, especially with something with this many layers, for it to slide back. When you do pressings with thinner materials, a great example is a 1/16 of an inch maple veneer. You know, 1 inch stack, if you were laminating something that was 1 inch thick, we would have 16 layers of this material, which means that there's, I think, 15 glue lines. 15 glue lines is substantial, and a three-dimensional shape that's laminated with 15 glue lines, you're gonna be hard-pressed for it to actually pull back to flat. When you press with 1/8 inch material like Baltic birch, it means that to achieve 1 inch, you would need 8 layers of material, and there would be 7 glue lines. Those 7 glue lines, over time, because there's less glue holding it in that three-dimensional shape, will tend to relax and slightly pull back. So if you want really strong pressings that will hold their shape for a long time, I highly recommend a thinner material like 1/16 of an inch maple or birch or whatever, but a solid wood material over a laminated material, plywood, like what Baltic birch is. The other disadvantage of Baltic birch is that the 1/8 material is made up of 3 plies of material, and so it's already a laminate. It's already been pressed together to hold a flat shape. And when you try to pull it around a three-dimensional shape, you'll find it much more difficult to do over top of a material that is not laminated, like what the maple is. And you'll achieve stronger, more three-dimensional shapes using the thinner material. So a couple of advantages over top of the maple veneer. Anyways, that's the little lesson today about what's actually happening. It's the shear line that holds everything together, and I hope you enjoyed this.